I am Brother Stephen Elabo, welcoming you to Deeper Life Bible Church, Charlottesville, United States, a place where the undiluted Word of God is being preached. You are about to listen to our General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumoye, as he comes forth to share the mind of God with you and your family. I want you to be ready. Pick up your pen and your paper and jot down important messages as they will do you good. God bless you and remain blessed.
Sit down. I'm coming to Hosea chapter 10. The book of Hosea is a very interesting book. It is prophetic. It is powerful. It promises a lot of things. As you come here, there is a central verse. There is a verse that indicates what God is going to do. It's in Hosea chapter 10 verse 12. He gives us a commandment because he's leading us to the way to conquer our problem. It says tonight is in your hands. You are going to be healed. You are going to be delivered. It's going to save your soul. It's going to restore you. Did you hear that, sister? When she was in the hospital, about to deliver, and the boys came to her. No lack, no loss, no limitation. The boys is coming to you tonight. All the lack in your life will be supplied. Tonight, everything you have lost will be restored. Tonight, you are the man, there's no limitation in your life again. You turn to the right, there will be a miracle. You're moving back to your office tomorrow, there is a miracle. You go to the market, there is a miracle. On your way as we go back home tonight, miracle will accompany you back home. Look at Hosea chapter 10 verse 12. Sow to yourself in righteousness. Reap in mercy. Break up your fallow ground. For it is time to seek the Lord till he come and rain righteousness upon you. You see what Hosea is telling us. He says, break up your fallow ground. You see, look up here. Some hard, some grounds as hard as this ground in front of me like
cement.
And if you drop anything there, it will not enter. Some hearts are hard. Miracle wants to enter. Healing wants to enter. Salvation wants to enter. The power of God wants to enter. And the heart is so hard. They've been going to church for a long time. They've been religious for a long time. They've been hearing the preaching for a long time. They've been baptized in water. They've been confirmed. And every Sunday they go to church. They know the Bible references. They know their catechism. And they know everything. And the heart is
hard.
And the time of rain has come. Look up here. If you remove this roof and the rain begins to fall on this solid cement ground, anything you put there, whether you put corn or you put cassava or you put yam, it will not bear any fruit. It is so hard. You cannot plant anything. That's why Hosea says the rain is about to fall. The power is about to come. He says, break up your fallow ground. Break up that hardened ground. Because tonight, the night of power, the night of miracle, the night of signs and wonders. But Hosea said, let's cooperate together. Let's work together. Let's have agreement together. Because we're going to pray tonight. Kind of prayer you have never heard. There's anointing tonight. A kind of anointing you have never seen. There is a manifestation tonight. A kind of manifestation you have never seen. Barrenness will vanish away tonight. Brain problem will vanish away tonight. All your yokes are broken tonight. Hosea said, the prophet is saying, the messenger of God is saying, break up your fallow ground. Then it says, sow to yourself in mercy. You sow to yourself in righteousness. After you break up the fallow ground. Have you seen our farmers? And they get to the farm. They cultivate the land. They remove all the obstacles. They get all the stones away. And they begin to make all those hills and edges. And then they put all the fertilizer. And then they plant the yam. They plant the cassava. They sow in uprightness. They sow as they ought to sow. They don't just come. They just cut all the seed there. They have to break up that ground. They have to make it soft. If your heart is soft, a miracle will drop there. If your heart is submissive, the power of God will come there tonight. And you sow yourself in righteousness. And you reap in mercy. Tonight is the night of reaping. I said tonight is the night of reaping. You will reap in joy. You will reap a miracle. You will reap the power of God. And then it says, break up your fallow ground. Because it is time. It is time to seek the Lord. When are you going to be saved? When are you going to be restored? When are you going to be strengthened? All those powers that oppress you at night and oppress you on the bed at night. When are you going to be delivered? When will the rain come upon you? This marriage of 15 years, 18 years, when will the child come? All the poverty, when will it go away? All the sorrow, when will it go away? All your tears, when will it dry up? Tonight is your night. Because it is time. You've been marking time. You've gone here, you've gone there. You've gone up, you've gone down. You've gone to prophet, you've gone to priest. You've gone to church, you've gone to shrine. Now you've come to miracle ground. Somebody there, where are you? The Lord will find you out tonight. He will put a miracle in your life. Because it is time to seek the Lord until He comes and He rains righteousness upon you. The rain of miracle. A reign of redemption. A reign of power. A reign of liberation. I'm speaking to you tonight from the book of Hosea on seeking the Lord for showers of blessing. I see your miracle very near. Seeking the Lord for showers of blessing.
We were Olua fun ojo ibukun.
Osia goes back.
Osia pada seyin.
He wants to tell us why the people were suffering.
O fe so idi abajo te se njiya fun
wa. He wants to tell you why we've been suffering.
O fe so idi ta fi njiya fun wa.
When God created you.
Nipa t'Olorun seda.
Forget about every other person.
Tabi elomi.
You in particular.
Iwo ga fun rara re.
God molded you.
Olorun lo mo.
God created you.
Olorun lo seda.
And God put you in this place.
Olorun wa fi o sin.
He had a great ambition for you.
O wa ni ilepa to lagbara
fun. A great possession for you.
Ogun to se yebiye fun
o. It is not where you are now that God earmarked for you.
Ibi to wa iko Olorun pe
o. It is not that poverty now that you experience that God earmarked for you.
O si tin ba ofira yo.
When God molded you and created you.
Nigba to Olorun mo to se da.
He has something great and fantastic for you.
Olorun ara, Olorun ara manda fun o.
But why have we not got it?
Kinu a de ti o ti te wa lowo.
Why have we not received?
And
Osea is going to tell us the reason.
Osea
said, I'll tell you.
Osea ni mo so fun.
It says, number one, the reason for horrible suffering.
Idi ti a fi njiya to
buru. The reason for horrible suffering.
Idi ti a fi njiya to buru.
And then it's not going to stop there.
Oni danudun be o.
He said, I told you that.
Oni mo ti so le fun o.
That where you are living is not God's destiny for you.
Ibi to wa ye ko la ye mo Olorun fun o.
That wilderness is not the divinely appointed place for you.
Akiju to wa ye iye gan ko Olorun
yin. Osea says you are suffering.
Osea lo njiya.
This is horrible. This is terrible. What you say, I'm telling you that. So you will know what got you there. So you will come out. Somebody that is coming out.
You're
coming out of that dungeon. The devil tried to put you inside the coffin. He showed you in the dream. He said, I'm going to bury you. Bury your destiny. Bury your prospect.
It's
going to bury your prosperity.
It's
going to bury your life. And then he showed you the coffin.
Said,
that's where I'm going to put you. I'm going to nail that coffin. You woke up, you were sweating. But I came to tell you tonight. You're coming out of that coffin. I came to tell you tonight. All that wood will make firewood out of that wood of that coffin. Because you're coming out. I see you there, you are coming out. I see your tears, God is going to wipe you away. And Osea tells us how that will happen. Number two, the return of humble seekers. The seeking for something. I'm sure you are not a little boy. You're a man. A woman. You left your house tonight. And you came over here. You're a responsible man. You're a responsible woman. You're looking for something. You are not satisfied how you are, where you are. That thing you're seeking for, your final bus stop has now arrived. You will see him here tonight. Nothing you're looking for. Nothing you're seeking. Tonight is your night. Congratulations. I say congratulations over here.
That
good thing you're seeking. Tonight you will discover. Number two, the return of the humble seekers. Number three is the rain of heavenly showers. The rain of heavenly showers. Pay attention to Osea.
Let us see Osea.
Because Osea is going to tell us. Number one, the reason. Number one, the reason. The reason for horrible suffering. Number two, the return of humble seekers. Number three, the rain of heavenly showers. Number one, the reason for horrible suffering. Well, I've read everything and I'm going to just paraphrase everything for you. Look at Hosea chapter 4. Reading from verse 1. It says, hear the word of the Lord. It says, here is what we suffer. It says, that the reason we suffer. Yes, the reason for our sorrow. Yes, the reason for heart attack. This is written for reason for separation, the family and divorce. This is the reason for our poverty. He goes on to tell them when he said, hear the word of the Lord. In that verse 1, he said, because there is no truth. He said, there's deception everywhere. Look at verse 2. He said, by swearing and lying and killing and stealing.
He said,
we kill one another. He said, we're stealing. He said, we're lying. And then he said in verse 4, yet let no man strive,
nor
reprove another. For my people are as they that strive with the priest.
He said,
the reason why we suffer.
He
said, there is no respect for God.
There
is no respect for the priest.
He
said, we fight. He said, we steal. He said, we lie. Then he goes on in chapter 5. He tells us in verse 3. He said, I know. He said, don't you think I don't know? Don't suggest I don't know. He said, I know why you're suffering. And then he goes on to tell us why we're suffering. And he talks about defilement. And he talks about pride. And he talks about our sickness. You see, as we look at our lives, there is no suffering without sin. Sin and suffering, they go together. Sin and sorrow, they go together. And Hosea is telling us,
it
says, the reason why we suffer, terrible suffering, horrible suffering, unbearable suffering,
it's
because of our sin. In chapter 6, it goes on. It says, it's because of our transgression. Chapter 6 and verse 7.
He
said, but they, like men, have transgressed the covenant.
Only said,
there is no law. Everybody is like, we are lawless. We get anywhere. We do anything. And we do not know. We are the people that are fashioning the sea court of abundance. And then he goes on to tell us in verse 10. He says, I have seen horrible sin in the house of Israel. He says, there is quarrel from
Ephraim.
And Israel is defiled. He said, now we don't even think anything about adultery. The married woman would dress up and leave the husband at home and go to another man.